Hello everybody, I am Dr. Jitendra Pandey and today we are going to discuss wireless security issues. Internet users are widely using Wi-Fi devices to access internet. Every year millions of Wi-Fi devices are sold in the market. Out of these, most of the wireless devices are vulnerable in their default configuration mode. Since end users are not fully aware of the security levels to be set on these devices, these get rendered vulnerable. By taking advantage of these unsecured Wi-Fi devices, terrorists and hackers fulfill their needs. Anyone with Wi-Fi connectivity in his computer, laptop, or mobile can connect to unsecured access point or wireless routers. Anyone in the range of access point can connect to an access point if it is unsecured. Once the connection is established, the attacker can send mails, download classified or confidential stuff, initiate attack on other computers in the network, send malicious code to others, install a Trojan or botnet on the victim's computer to get long-term control on it through internet, etc. All these criminal acts will naturally be associated with the legal user of access point or the wireless router. It is up to the legal user of the access point to defend himself to prove that he has not been involved in these acts. It now becomes the responsibility of the user to secure his or her own access point. Let's see some real incidents that took place in the recent years. Terrorists and hackers used unsecured access point to perform illegal activities on the internet. Hackers penetrated into open Wi-Fi network of luxury hotels owned by Thomson Group in New York, Los Angeles, and Washington, D.C. and stole the private emails sent by the guests. The hackers then attempted to extort money from the hotel chain by threatening to publish the emails. Next incident. Just 5 minutes before the Delhi blast on September 2008, terrorists used an unsecured Wi-Fi connection of a company at Chembur in Mumbai to send terror emails to authorities and news channels. These hackers do not leave a trail of footprints for the investigators to arrive at a logical conclusion. The audit trail ends at Wi-Fi access point of legal user. So it becomes imperative for the users to secure their own access point or wireless router. Types of attacks on wireless environment. Number one is denial of service attack. Denial of service attack aims at preventing the users from accessing the network resources. In a wireless network, denial of service attack can be applied in various ways. Second is man-in-middle attack in Wi-Fi device. Performing man-in-middle attack in the wireless network is much easier when compared to wired network. As the transmissions from an access point is broadcasted, it is easy for an unauthorized user to collect the traffic sent by other wireless clients. And the process of collecting the packets in this manner is known as eavesdropping. Also, the third-party user can manipulate the packets sent to the legitimate users, which results in breaking the user privacy. So, in order to avoid these kind of attacks, strong encryption should be used for transmitting the data between wireless client and access point. Wardriving. Wardriving is a process of tracking Wi-Fi hotspots located at a particular place while moving with a handheld device or a laptop in a vehicle. This helps the user in finding out the access points that does not use encryption and take control over it for performing the attacks on the network. Now let us see how the attack occurs in Wi-Fi environment. At the physical layer of TCP/IP model, denial of service attack can be implemented by introducing a device which will generate noise in the same frequency band in which wireless access point is operating. This makes the users who are trying to connect to the access point may not be able to connect to it. Also, the other possibility of denial of service attack is spoofing the access point. Normally, wireless clients connect to the wired network with the help of an access point. For associating with the access point, they require SSID of it. When an unauthorized user places an access point with the same SSID, then there is a chance of authorized user getting associated with the attacker's access point. If that happens, the attacker will try to collect sufficient number of packets from the wireless client and crack the WEP key using the legitimate access point. Then the attacker gets associated with the legitimate access point and generates large ping request in the network or generates some abnormal traffic, which may finally result in denial of service attack. Guidelines for securing wireless communications. Always use a strong password for encryption. A strong password should have at least 15 characters, uppercase letters, lowercase letters, numbers, and symbols. It is recommended to change the encryption key frequently so that it makes difficult for the cracker to break the encryption key. Do not use WEP encryption. Rather, use WPA or WPA2 encryption. Always use the maximum key size supported by access point for encryption. If the key size is large enough, then it takes more time to crack the key by the hacker. Also, it is recommended to change the encryption key frequently so that it makes difficult for the cracker to break the encryption key. Isolate the wireless network from the wired network with a firewall and an antivirus gateway. Do not connect the access point directly to the wired network, as there is a chance of compromised wireless client, in turn affecting the system in the wired network. A firewall and an antivirus gateway should be placed between the access point and the wired network. Restrict access to the access point based on MAC address. In order to allow authorized users to connect to the access point, wireless clients should be provided access based on MAC address. Change the default username and password of the access point. Most of the users do not change the default passwords while configuring the access point, but it is recommended to keep a strong password, as this default password information can be known from product manufacturers. Shut down the access point when not in use. Hackers try to brute force the password to break the keys, so it is good practice to turn off the access point during extended periods of non-use. Do not broadcast your network name. SSID information is used to identify an access point in the network, and also the wireless clients connect to the network using this information. Hence, in order to allow authorized users to connect to the network, the information should not be provided in public. Always maintain an updated firmware. Updating the firmware of access point is recommended, as it will reduce the number of security loopholes in the access point. Use VPN or IPsec for protecting communication. When the information flowing from wireless client to the wireless network receiver is critical, then it is recommended to use virtual private network or IP security based communication so that the information is protected from the sniffers in the network. Do not make the SSID information public. SSID information is used to identify an access point in the network, and also the wireless clients connect to the network using this information. Hence, in order to allow authorized users to connect to the network, the information should not be provided in public. Disable DHCP service. When the number of users accessing the access point is less, it is recommended to disable the DHCP service. as this may make the attackers easy to connect to the network once they get associated with the access point. I hope you will be able to secure your wireless devices now. Thank you very much.